Right, the members of the committee have had an opportunity to glance at my submission. I will realise that it was rather lengthy. And of course, this is all short and sweet because if you call this democracy, it's rather robust. It was obviously anticipated during the opening debate that there would be plenty of opposition, and that is obviously manifested with the number of submissions that have been made. All I will do is just reiterate the headings that I've used at the start of my submission, because for me personally it was significant time when I came across two people who were able to lead me to information regarding fluoride, and that was 1975. Being a country boy, I was rather ignorant about the whole thing up until then, and frankly I was horrified and shocked, and have done everything since to avoid it. I think the thing I would like to emphasise the most is this book, Nutrition and Physical Regeneration by Weston Price, who was in fact a very distinguished American dentist. And he toured the world in the 1930s, including coming here to New Zealand for 18 days, in which he covered roughly 100 miles every day, a lot of it over very rough country tracks. And of course, what he reveals in that book is really the answer to tooth decay. And that is, it's nutrition. And as a landowner would say, location, 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 I say nutrition, nutrition, nutrition. And anything else is just a load of codswallop. And I also indicated here, as part of my submission, some of the history that led to the adoption, of course, first in America, but not very long thereafter in New Zealand. After all, it all started in Hastings in 1954, and one of my dear old heroes, Dr. Eva Hill, was campaigning against this in Hastings at the Municipal Theatre there in 1955. Because it's obvious, if you go into the history of fluoridation, that the whole thing is based on propaganda. It's not based on scientific facts at all. The science is not settled. That statement in itself is just propaganda. And I think we had a very good example of this in that comedy program that follows TV3 News, Monday of last week. It's called Project. And probably the only reason why I watched it was because it was promoted heavily in the news beforehand. Now, that was propaganda. It repeated the statistics that come from the Ministry of Health. It even insulted people who opposed fluoridation, and I can't remember, because I haven't watched it again, whether it was specifically the clinical psychologist was commenting about those who don't vaccinate or those who don't agree with fluoridation, but it was both together. And how are we going to convince these people that they've got it wrong? Well, you know, once again, that was just insulting. Now, who's responsible for that? I'd have to ask TV3, wouldn't I? But frankly,
We take our submissions from you, so we haven't actually taken them as a submission. So we're just interested in your viewpoint today.
Yes, well, yeah. I'm speaking to the submission and just outlining various things here.
We've got about 1 minute left. It goes very quickly. We've got about 1 minute left.
Yeah, okay. I'll comment on what you said in the opening debate, Mrs. Currier. You said that this is a health issue. I say it's a matter of personal liberty. It's got little to do with health. I acknowledge, Mrs. Stewart, that the New Zealand First has indicated that they don't support this bill. With that proviso, I thought the contribution from that New Zealand First representative was a little weak, but at least it wasn't full of innuendo and all the rubbish that I've been talked about in my submission about being pseudoscience and whatever. I make no hesitation in stating, and let's face it, I've read many books over the last 35 years and informed myself on the subject, the pseudoscience comes from those who promote fluoride.
Thank you. Nicely timed. We appreciate your submission.